This is a video about resonance. Imagine you were abducted by aliens, and they wanted you to describe what a rhinoceros is. And you quickly realized that your language and their language did not have enough vocabulary words in common for you to properly convey to them what a rhinoceros is. You eventually settled on the description of a rhinoceros is a cross between an elephant and a unicorn. You were happy because you were describing a big gray animal with a horn on its head. They were happy because they thought that they knew what you were talking about. You just used resonance to describe a rhinoceros. The definition of resonance is, if multiple Lewis structures can be written with the same position of atoms, but different positions of electrons, the actual structure is an average. This is going to be true of either molecules or polyatomic ions. The key here is that the only difference is position of electrons. You are not moving atoms. These are the three resonance structures for the carbonate ion, CO32-. Notice that they all have their atoms in the same locations. Carbon is in the center. Carbon is bonded to three oxygens. What's different about these structures is the positioning of the electrons. So in each structure, you see that one of the oxygens is double bonded to the carbon, two of them are single bonded. These three structures have that double bonded oxygen in different locations. So it's at the top, then it's at the bottom left, then it's at the bottom right. Also, these structures all satisfy the octet rule. They are all valid Lewis structures. But there's a problem with all of these Lewis structures. These oxygens, they are all the same element. They have absolutely equal electronegativities. These oxygens are playing a little game of tug of war. They're all trying to pull electrons towards them. The fact that they are the same element means that they have absolutely equal strengths in every way, so they are in a stalemate. These bonds are not single bonds, they are not double bonds, they are an average. They are going to be somewhere in the vicinity of 1 1/3 bonds. This is not a chemical reaction. We are not switching between the various resonance structures. The real structure is going to be an average. Resonance structures always need to be separated by the same type of arrow. A resonance arrow is a two-headed arrow with a single line in the middle. Resonance arrow. Chemistry is picky about the specific type of arrow that you're drawing. This specific type of arrow means it is separating resonance structures. Let's go back to our example of the rhinoceros. We described a rhinoceros as a cross between an elephant and a unicorn. To put that in terms of resonance structures, I could say that a rhinoceros has two resonance structures, one being an elephant, one being a unicorn. Now, which of the following is true? Option one, if you take 100 photos of a rhinoceros, half of them, it's going to look like a photo of an elephant, half of them is going to look like a photo of a unicorn. Or option two, if you take 100 photos of a rhinoceros, all of them are going to look like a rhinoceros with some features of an elephant, some features of a unicorn. It's that option too. I can say the same thing about resonance structures. If I take a bunch of still images of a carbonate ion, none of them are ever going to look like one single resonance structure. They are all going to look like the average of these structures. These carbon-oxygen bonds, in the case of carbonate ions, should be 1 1/3 bonds. Thanks for watching Chemistry in a Nutshell. If you feel that I've earned it, please like this video and subscribe to my channel.